Hello everyone, my name is Sara and I'm a sixth year medical student at University of Rijeka, and today I will talk about hereditary hemorrhagic telangiectasia or Rondeau-Osler-Weber syndrome related to iron deficiency anemia. It's a rare genetic disorder with autosomal dominance characterized by the typical pathological and clinical findings as telangiectasias and arteriovenous malformations. Epistaxis is often the first and leading manifestation. In this case, we'll be presented a 78-year-old male patient presented to the Department of Hematology with worsening of the clinical picture in the past month, having had epistaxis episodes, and symptoms were followed by low hemoglobin level, serum iron, ferritin, and decreased levels of hematocrit, demonstrating iron deficiency anemia. During the physical exam, we noticed telangiectasias throughout his face, ears, and hands. A CT scan showed a hypodense liver and spleen structures that were described as telangiectasias. Next, endoscopy was performed, and the results indicated multiple gastric and duodenal angiodysplasias with recent bleeding. Therapy approach included catheter embolization, proton pump inhibitors, oral iron supplementation, and red blood cell transfusion. And this condition often led to hypoxemia, dyspnea, and especially iron deficiency anemia as a result of intermittent gastrointestinal bleeding caused by angiodysplasia lesions. Angiodysplasia lesions are more commonly situated in the stomach or duodenum than in the colon. And to conclude, clinical manifestation of this disease are often under-recognized, so it's crucial to perform correct diagnosis to prevent systemic complications. So we emphasize awareness raising in the clinical management and improvement of quality of life for those patients. Thank you for listening.